Well, praise God. We're back with the Word and Spirit. Welcome, Church on the Rock family, and all the guests and all our family and friends. We're going to get into Word today. We're going to continue along the lines of walking out and fulfilling your purpose and destiny. We talked about it some last week, but it was more that we needed to cover. Mm-hmm. And so we want to get in the Word to let everybody understand that God has a plan for your life.
Yes.
Pastor, since you said last week, God would not allow you to come to this earth without a plan,
That's right. Without purpose,
and without destiny. And so the key to your successful venture on this planet is make sure that you stand perfect and complete in all the will of God, that everything He assigned for you to do while you're here on this planet, you get it done.
Yes.
We talked about that last week. One of the number one challenges in people's life is fulfilling that what God has assigned. So many people go to the grave.
Yes.
And what God has purpose for them does not get done. Mm-hmm. Praise God. We don't want that to happen to us. And so we want to be people of the Word and people that follow the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
That's why we call ourselves Word and Spirit Churches. Amen. Because we're people that want the Word to reveal to us.
Yes.
And we want people to be people that are led by the Spirit of God. And that's how you do it, through the Word and through the Spirit.
Yes.
As I yield and obedient to the Word and obedient to the Spirit, I'm going to fulfill what God has signed for me.
Mm-hmm.
And then you hear, what do you hear when you hear and you get to, what do you hear when you get to heaven? Well done, thou good and faithful servant.
Yes.
Instead of getting there and hear, well, what happened?
Right.
You don't want to have to explain what happened. Praise God.
Yes.
You just want to hear, well done. Well, Pastor said to go ahead and welcome everybody in.
All right.
Praise
well, hello, God. Church family. How are you doing? It's good to be here tonight. First of all, before we start, I want to just thank all of you all for just showing so much kindness to me Sunday for Mother's Day. It was just such a blessing. You know, I got cards in the mail, drive-bys, you know, people sending gifts and everything.
Amen.
So I just appreciate you all honoring me during this season. I was not expecting anything. So I really appreciate those that just showed acts of kindness, even to my husband. Thank you.
Well, praise God.
For being kind. And my children, they were just, it's my day. Normally Mother's Day is my day.
Praise
so
God.
I just appreciate that. And so I just pray blessings upon you. And I just want you to go get your pen and your paper, go get your tablets, because it's a joy to know that we're not here on this earth without a plan. God has a plan for your life, and Pastor Keith is going to take us into the Word of God concerning that. And so you are unique, you are special in the eyes of God.
Amen. And I got about 18 scriptures. You know, we never cover 18 scriptures. So I may just state them so you can write them down. And talking about your purpose and destiny.
Mm-hmm.
And this is very important what we're going to cover today, because what we're going to look at is that God makes sure that you understand His plan, His provision, the dominion He's given you, the wealth He's given you, the assignment He's given you.
Mm-hmm.
And He did the same with Adam. He did the same with Jesus, and He's doing the same with us.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to take a look at Adam. We want to take a look at the life of Jesus. And we want to take a look at our lives to understand what He did for them, He's done for us.
Yes.
You know,
Amen.
He assigned their dominion. He assigned their likeness. He assigned their dominion.
Mm-hmm.
He assigned them provision. Then He gave them the assignment on their life, and He even gave them wealth.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to understand, we must understand that we need those things too.
Mm-hmm.
That we cannot fulfill our assignment without the same provision and without the same investment into us. We have to have those things in order to fulfill the Great Commission on our lives.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yeah, one of the things I'm thinking about as you're talking is in Matthew 6, where it says to seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Because if you don't...
Well, that's one of the provisions.
Right. Praise God.
I got that down as a scripture.
Okay.
One of the provisions.
Because if you don't wake up daily seeking His kingdom...
Your provision is tied to that.
Because we're not of this world. Jesus told us, He said, you're not of this world. We're just visiting. So we're of the kingdom of light, and there's a kingdom of darkness. So we're not just talking about your job and just first. We're talking about God's plan first. Hit the relationship that you should have with Him first.
That's
and
right.
Then all these things will come into
everything's
in line.
Already been taken
so
care of.
Just advancing God's kingdom is what I'm trying to say. We got to learn to wake up daily, advance in His kingdom, doing things His way.
That's right. Praise God. So get your Bible. You may want to start your, what's it called, your watch party.
Yes, do your watch party.
Praise God. You want to get your Bible and go ahead and start your watch party, because we're going to do a salvation prayer at the end of at the end of our session today. So that if somebody else is watching this and they're not born again, it gives them an opportunity to make Jesus Christ the Lord of their lives. So just push and publish on your Facebook or sharing the YouTube message. You know, we're streaming two different ways. We're using Facebook and we're using YouTube. So people can, they don't have Facebook. So some people don't want Facebook. So we're using YouTube as well. And this gives you a chance to share it in two different ways.
Yeah. Or maybe you know someone that needs to hear this, because during this lifetime, people can get down. They feel like they don't have a purpose. They have no hope. And you can just tag their name to watch this video. I was seeing someone today thanking one of their friends for showing them their video from their church service. And then they said, when church starts back up, I'm going to start coming.
Praise
so some
God.
People need that. They need to get that, you know, be revived back into spiritual things. They want that. So you might know someone. So tag them along in your video.
Amen. So the Bible, we can say the Bible is God's plan for man. And when you read the Bible, you're reading about people that entered the plan. And you're reading about people that entered, carried it out, and finished it. And then you read about people that started, got to the middle, and didn't finish. Somebody like Samson, he didn't finish out the assignment God had on his life. His life was cut short. And then you're reading about people that never entered into it. Like Esau. He just never started the plan of God for his life.
He never, gave it up.
He gave it up. And so the Bible said these things are written for our learning. So that as we understand that God's going to allot you so much time on this planet.
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
He's going to allot you so much time on the planet. Really, the planet is 120 years.
Yeah.
Praise God, it's 120 years. Mm-hmm. It's what we, it's the last, breath of time that He gave us to be on this planet. And praise God, next year I'll be 60.
Woo!
I'm halfway there. I'm halfway there.
You believe
praise God. I still, I'd like to think I'm smarter. You will be smarter.
Yeah,
I'm going to be smarter in the last 60 than I was the first. Praise
God. That's good.
You should get smarter as you go through this thing. Praise God. Well, let's get into Word. And let's go over here and look at let's go over here and look at Jeremiah. That's where we started last week. Jeremiah. And then we looked at Jeremiah chapter 1. And then we looked at Jeremiah 29. So we're just going to kind of touch on these and just a little bit of review, because we got a lot to cover today. And Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5, God declared, "Before I formed you in the belly," He says, "I knew thee. And before thou camest out of the womb, I sanctified thee and ordained thee a prophet unto the nation." So we can see right here, God had already had a plan before Jeremiah ever came out of his mother's womb. God had a plan for his life that he didn't know about. And so the plan has to be discovered. The plan has to be discovered. And how is it discovered? It's discovered in communication with our Heavenly Father. God wants to talk to us just like He talked to Jeremiah. And then in Jeremiah 29:11, He says, the plan will be discovered as you seek me, as you come after me, then I'm going to be found of you, and you're going to understand who you are. You know, I'm thinking about the disciples. They followed Jesus long enough to finally Jesus said, "Who do you say that I am?" And then He told them who they were.
Yes, that's right.
You got to stay long enough till you find out who you
Amen.
Are.
Amen.
You got to find out. You got to stay long enough with God till you begin to understand who He is.
Yes.
And how much He loves you and how committed He is to you. And you got to understand His commitment to you. And a lot of people don't understand how committed God is to your success and to fulfill the plan. He has more come. He has more to gain than in us fulfilling the plan.
Yes, that's right.
Than we think. Amen.
Oh,
he is totally behind us, and he is cheering and wanting us to get this thing done.
Yes, yes.
Because it fulfills his overall plan for heaven and earth.
Yes. Amen. There's people that need you.
Right. There's people that's going to get blessed out of this thing.
Mm-hmm.
So he tells Jeremiah that you're a prophet. He gives him his assignment.
Mm-hmm.
He tells him where his assignment is going to be. Geography is involved in this thing.
Mm-hmm.
And where you're going to live at. All these things are involved. His authority is tied into his ordination.
Mm-hmm.
He becomes the voice of God. His prophet was to become the voice of God in the earth, to help people understand the word, to help people understand the word of God and help people fulfill their destiny.
Mm.
That was his assignment. And God told him it was a good plan. God told him it was a good plan, and it was a plan with no evil. God had no evil plan.
That's right.
I am not putting evil on you. I have a good plan to give you an expected end.
Yes.
And so the truth is that for every person that comes into this earth, God has a plan for them. So let's go back and look at Genesis chapter 1, the first man that God put in the earth. We're going to take a look at that.
And I just want to say, even when you do know, like you said at the beginning, you know that God has a plan for your life, pressure can come against your life to make you stop in that plan, in pursuing the plan. Pressure doesn't mean that God has stopped the plan for your life. God's plan continues on through the pressures of life, whether it's your children, whether it's a job, whether it's anything in life that's bringing pressure against you. You still have to understand God's plan is still alive.
Right. And your authority, we're going to talk about this. The opposition that comes against you is not greater than the authority he gives you. God never gives you a plan that doesn't include your dominion.
That's right. That's right. Yeah.
Because he knows you're going to get opposition.
Mm-hmm.
But he wants you to have authority
over
that opposition.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Speak to
he wants you to have dominion over
the
that opposition.
The storms and the rain.
Right.
Speak.
So if we look down here in Genesis chapter 1, 26, after God recreates the earth, and he says here, and God said, let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and the fowls of the air and over the cattle and over all the earth.
Mm-hmm.
His dominion covers the entire planet, this man's dominion that we call Adam, and over every creeping thing that creep upon the earth. So we notice right here, when God's plan includes a couple of things right here. One is his likeness. God wants us like him. The plan of God is that man be like him. And when we look at Jesus Christ and we look at his life, you want to write this scripture down. It's Hebrews chapter 1, around in verse 3. I believe it's verse 3. It says that Jesus Christ is the express image of God. That's who he is. God wants man like him. He wants him to function like him. He wants his expression and his words and his actions to be exactly his words and actions in the earth.
Yes, yes.
That is the plan of God for my life. And one of the things we have to accept is it is God's will that we function like him. Now, for us, I give you a scripture so that you can go back to this. It's in Ephesians 4:24. You don't have to turn there. But the Bible says, put on this likeness, which is after God created in after his likeness in righteousness and true holiness. And when we talk about righteousness, righteousness means that I stay with the plan that God assigned me. I stay with the nature he assigned me. I stay with what God has for me. Righteousness is living out what God has for you. Holiness is setting my life apart. It's part of that consecration to the plan of God. So God gave Adam his likeness, Jesus his likeness, and he's treating us the same way and giving us his likeness. In Romans chapter 8, around verse 32, it says the plan of God was to conform us to the image of his son. And we ought to be, in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 says, imitators of God. Amen. God gives us the ability to be like him. It's not something I have to work for.
Right, yes.
Adam did not go to college mm-hmm. or to Bible school to be like mm-hmm. God. God just put his nature on the inside of him. Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah. And so what he does is give us the same nature that he has in his son, Jesus mm-hmm. Christ. We have that same right. nature.
And I'm glad you said that, to be conformed to the image of his son. I'm thinking a lot of times people are looking outwardly. I mean, when you say that, people think I'm supposed to look like Jesus outwardly. But no, it's the inward nature. Right. And the more you renew your mind, the more you put on Christ. It says to put on the Lord Jesus. And that's the nature of God. It depends upon how you respond to people, right. what you say to people, how you are patient with people. Because when you see yourself acting differently than what you should, you know, no, this is God on the inside of me acting like this. Right. I'm not responding like I would respond. This is God. Because even Paul said, I'm constrained
by the love of God.
Right, by the love of God. So the reason why I'm acting kind, the reason why I'm being patient, the reason why I'm not responding, because I'm putting on the Lord Jesus Christ today. Right. Amen? And that's how you do it. Just respond the way Jesus would respond. You remember years ago they had WWJD. Right. What would Jesus do? That's exactly what you do. That's how you let people know that I'm being transformed and conformed to the image of God.
That's right. Well, the thing is, the nature's already in us. Mm-hmm. When we get born again, his nature's in. So I didn't have to try to be like him. Mm-hmm. I was made like him. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I was made righteous.
Right.
That's I was
right.
made that Adam was made and created to be like God.
Amen.
Jesus is God manifested in the flesh. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yeah.
And he is the express image of God. Mm-hmm. So if you want to know what God is like, mm-hmm. you just read Matthew, Mark, Luke, mm-hmm. and John, and the book of Revelation, mm-hmm. and you'll understand what he's like.
Yes.
Amen. You'll understand what he's like. Well, then he made us like him, mm-hmm. and he put that nature on the inside of us. Then we get in the word and to accept, that's my new identity.
Yes, that's right.
This is who I am. This mm-hmm. is my new identity. Yes. Because you cannot fulfill the plan without the identity. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You cannot fulfill the assignment that God has for us.
Yes.
You cannot fulfill your destiny mm-hmm. without the nature.
Yes, yes.
That's
yes.
why it's yes. so important. The assignment that God put on my life mm-hmm. takes his nature to fulfill.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember I was working in a school system years ago, and the secretary was known to be a Christian. I just remember all the teachers said she's a Christian, but she was so hateful. I don't even know if she was a Christian. I don't even know if she was born again. But she just went to church, okay? And everybody knew she went to church.
Right.
But the way she treated the people around her was just so hateful that you were wondering, God, is this real? So God is wanting to change man on the inside out. Because he said, I draw you to me by my loving kindness.
Right.
And my tender mercies do I draw men unto me. So that loving kindness and tender mercies on the inside of us to draw people unto God.
Right. Well, you know, in Romans 12, verse 1 and 2, mm-hmm. it says it's the transforming of the mind. Mm-hmm. My spirit is already like God. Mm-hmm. And one of the things we have to understand, the assignment is with my spirit.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
I renew my mind so that my soul does not fight mm-hmm. the image of God mm-hmm. and the likeness of God.
Yes.
I renew my mind so that there's not a war within me to fighting me on the inside, trying to keep me from fulfilling God's will.
Yes.
So God gives us instruction in the word.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to renew your mind.
Yes.
What does that mean? I have to take these thoughts of mm-hmm. God. And I have renew my mind. I have to take the old thoughts out and replace them with the thoughts of God in order to prove out what it says, mm-hmm. what is the good, perfect, and acceptable will of God. Mm-hmm. So in order to walk in the plan of God for me, I have to have a renewed mind.
Yes.
That's the reason why we have these sessions.
That's right.
Sessions are mind-renewing sessions.
Yes.
It helps you to understand, wait a minute, mm-hmm. I already have his likeness.
Right.
I'm already like him. Mm-hmm. Created in righteous and true. That's who I am.
Just renew your mind.
Well, I might as well go ahead and live it now. I might even need to catch up with myself.
Mm-hmm.
The renewing of the mind helps me catch up with myself.
Mm-hmm.
And so we see that Jesus and Adam had the image and likeness of
mm-hmm.
God.
Mm-hmm.
So in order to fulfill the plan, I need the same thing.
Yes, yes.
Then we saw right here and saying, and over here in Genesis chapter 1, he gave them dominion.
Mm-hmm.
You can't fulfill God's plan without dominion. You can't.
That's right.
You can't fulfill the plan of God. You can't walk out the purpose of destiny heaven has for you without his nature.
That's right.
And then without the dominion he's given you. Then if I'm going to finish, I'm going to be a dominator.
Yeah, amen.
Because you just talked about the challenges going to come. The challenges are going to come. Roadblocks are going to come. But God wants you to be able to speak to him.
That's right.
With dominion.
Amen.
Dominion is to make you a dominator in the realm that he's called you to function in.
Amen.
When you just read Jeremiah, you're going to be a dominator where? In the office of the prophet. In the nations that I called you to. Amen.
Yes.
God told Adam, your dominion is the whole planet. Jesus' dominion is heaven and earth. He said, all power, that's over in Matthew 28, all power around Matthew 28, 18, all power in heaven and earth has been given to me. But then he turns around to us in Matthew chapter 16, around verse 19. Here, I'm giving you all the keys to the kingdom of heaven.
Yes.
And whatever you bind on earth, amen, heaven's going to back you. And whatever you loose on earth, heaven's going to back you.
Yes.
And if you have faith in the assignment on your life, then you can speak to the mountain. And if you don't doubt your assignment and doubt your identity and doubt what I gave you and doubt who I assigned you to be
heart,
the mountain will move.
That's right.
Mountains move for people who know who they are. Mountains move for people that know their dominion.
Amen.
That know that heaven is backing them. Mountains move for people that know that wherever I go, Jesus is going with me.
Yes.
To help me fulfill my destiny. Angels are going with me. The Holy Ghost is going with me. That's why the Bible says you are more than a conqueror. Praise God
like
forever.
This pastor said once, he said that God has given us authority like he did Adam to keep the devil in check. You know, you keep him in check. When he shows up, you use your dominion and your authority. You let him know, no, you're not. No, you're not going to be over my finances. You're not over my health. Jesus died for everything, for you to increase and have life in everything. So your dominion, you're a child of God.
Right.
You are a child of God. Jesus was a child of God.
That's right.
So when he was here on the earth, everything moved because God was on the inside of him.
That's his assignment.
Yes.
It's got to move.
So when we
matter of fact,
show
it knows
up,
it's supposed
yes.
to. It knows it's
so
supposed to.
When we show
to.
Up, we are children of God.
Yeah.
And so things begin to move. And God left us his spirit on the end. The dominion comes out of your spirit, the Holy Ghost.
Right.
The same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells on the inside of you. And every demon and every angelic host knows what's on the inside
of you.
They
know we have the dominion.
Yes.
They know.
And they're waiting for you to use it.
And they're hoping, the devil is hoping we don't use it. The angels and all of creation that is aligned with God is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. How do you become a son? You got to have his nature to be his son.
Yes, that's right. Yes.
And God does not have a son. Both male and female, that he doesn't give his likeness and whose gives dominion to. And the thing is designed to move when you speak.
You know, you just said something to remind me of Jesus when he gave the, I think it was the 70 power, and then they came back recording.
That's right.
And they said, oh man, demons, they move.
They're subject to, under us.
Right,
they're
one of the things he said, rejoice in first. Don't rejoice in that first. But rejoice that your name is written in heaven first.
Then because why is your name written in heaven? Because to be born again means to be born from above. And just like when you are born in any city or any natural province, they record your birth record. And you can go down to the city hall or down to the city square and go to the place where they keep records.
Yes.
And they will have your birth record there. They will have your birth record. Well, when you got born in heaven, they got your record up there too. The Bible calls you a citizen of heaven. Your name is written in heaven.
And Jesus opened up the book.
So rejoice. Why? Because you are from above.
That's
anyway.
Right. That's right. You get like you said, you have to be a kingdom kid first.
That's
in
right.
order to use that dominion.
Right. Amen. The message was repent because the kingdom is here. Get ready to change what you think of. Repent doesn't mean I'm sorry.
Right.
It means to change.
Yes.
Change what? Change. I want to say change your address because you're from heaven. Praise God. You are from heaven and your assignment is here. You're from heaven and your assignment is here. You're children of your heavenly Father. And he wants you to have dominion,
yes,
to carry out kingdom business on this earth.
Yes.
And so I have to have this knowledge if I'm going to fulfill my destiny.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
I got to have it. Amen. So he gives him his nature. He gives him his dominion. Amen.
Yes.
And then the Bible said he blessed them.
Mm.
God always ministers the blessing,
yes,
of empowerment,
yes,
to his children. Mm-hmm. What does the blessing mean? The word blessing means empowered,
that's right,
to succeed.
Yes.
It means,
yes,
empowered to succeed at the assignment that God puts on your life. Every New Testament believer is going to finish. They're going to have the blessing.
That's right. Yeah.
You cannot fulfill your destiny without the nature.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot fulfill your destiny without the dominion.
Mm-hmm.
And you cannot fulfill your destiny without the empowerment of the blessing.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do it. And so God put the blessing. The Bible said that he blessed Adam and empowered him to succeed.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible said he blessed Jesus too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It tells us over in Galatians chapter 3, round of verse 18 and 19, that when God was blessing Abraham, he was talking to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
He was describing the blessing of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And as we continue to read in Galatians chapter 3, and the Bible said, if you belong to Christ,
mm-hmm,
then you are the seed of Abraham and heirs,
yes,
of the same blessing,
mm-hmm,
he put on Jesus.
Yes. Yeah.
And over it's over in the book of Acts, around chapter 3, around verse 26. The Bible said he sent Jesus to impart the blessing to us.
Mm-hmm.
The blessing's on you.
Amen.
You got to have the nature.
Power.
You got to have the dominion.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to have the blessing in order to fulfill the assignment on your life.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So now we go down here. Let's look at provision.
Okay.
Let's look at provision. Because God has provision for you.
Mm-hmm.
He has provision for your life. And one of the things that the devil wants people to struggle with is provision.
Mm.
He wants provision to cloud your mind when you miss your purpose and your destiny.
Mm-hmm.
He wants you working for provision,
yes,
when,
yes,
provision,
yes,
is already,
yes,
given. He wants you struggling. Your job is not your provision.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Your job should be a part of the assignment,
yeah,
on your,
right,
life, that God wants your light to shine in that place, because that place is not your,
yeah,
source. It's just
resource.
The resource.
Yeah.
And if God wants to change that resource,
yes,
in,
yes,
order for you to fulfill your destiny, he doesn't want you panicking.
All right. Yeah.
Your job says, well, we're laying off. Don't you lose heart over that. Because that job is not your source.
That's right.
It's just a resource.
Amen. Amen.
And the God of all resources,
mm-hmm,
has another place for you.
Yes.
You should just say, praise God, there's a ram in the bush,
mm-hmm,
waiting on me somewhere,
yes,
else.
Yes.
Amen. And that needs to come out of your mouth in order for it to manifest.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had some testimonies about people whose jobs during this coronavirus shutdown, and people's jobs and money's been affected.
Yeah.
But we've getting testimonies about where God had another place for you.
Yes.
The whole,
yes,
time,
yes,
he's got another source for you. Over in Psalms 145, the Bible said he opens his hand and all living is supplied.
Mm-hmm.
That's everything.
Yes.
That's saved,
yeah,
and unsaved.
Yes.
All living,
yes,
is provided for.
Mm-hmm.
Well, for us, we got special provision.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Amen. We got,
yeah,
special provision.
Yes.
And you quoted it, Matthew 6:33. 6:33, Matthew 6. If we seek the kingdom first,
mm-hmm,
what did Jesus do in the plan is saying? He said, Jesus said, I'm seeking the kingdom.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I'm after my Father's business.
Mm-hmm.
What was Adam's assignment?
Mm-hmm.
To do the will of the Father. And what happened? God told him, he says, and I'm going to read this. He says in verse 29, he says, and behold, God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, come on now,
mm-hmm,
and every tree which is the in which is the fruit, tree yielding seed, to be meat for you.
Mm-hmm.
So God says, I put your provision.
Yeah.
It's provision in all the earth.
Mm-hmm.
There's no place in the earth, if I send you there,
right, yes,
there's not provision,
yes,
there for,
yeah,
you. Amen.
Yeah. And one of the things you have to understand is God sending them there, because some people move out of what's going on in the city. You know, we've been pastors, and before we were pastors, we knew that God had us in New Albany, Indiana. Right. We never thought about moving, but you had opportunities through job promotions. And so some people will move out of God's plan over thinking, I'm going to get a promotion. And you don't do that. You stay where God has planted you, because God will promote you in that city. And so many times the devil has caused people to move from one city to the next. They've never been planted to find out where God has them.
Well, there's transition in the plan of God. Jesus was born in Bethlehem, moved to Egypt, came back to Nazareth, and then relocated in Capernaum. Now, the word said, the word called all those locations out. Mm-hmm. So if the word and spirit calls out the transition,
yes,
then I make the transition. Mm-hmm. But if I make it because I think it's good, mm-hmm, and I think it's going to be a profitable venture,
yes,
and I move out of what God, mm-hmm, has assigned me and provided me, that's when trouble,
yes,
starts.
Yes.
That's when trouble starts. If the word and the spirit dictate the move, then I move. Mm-hmm.
It reminds me of Ruth and Naomi, the book of Ruth, how Elimelech moved because there was a famine.
Right. When it seemed like it was profitable my life to move for money, mm-hmm, I knew I couldn't. Mm-hmm. Because I knew I was supposed to be with my pastor. Mm-hmm. I was supposed to be in the local church.
Yes.
And that was seeking the kingdom first. Mm-hmm. And that was my place of assignment, mm-hmm, to help in that ministry.
And you wouldn't be the pastor you are today.
You can't. Because now if you move, then there's things you should have learned at that location. Mm-hmm. Now you,
yes,
got problems. Mm-hmm. And the hardest thing for people to do is to go back.
Mm-hmm.
That's the hardest. When people make a decision to transition.
Right, that's right, yes.
The hardest thing to do and the most humbling thing to do is to go back. Because,
mm-hmm,
you off the plan now.
Yes, yes.
I'm thinking about Hagar. God, the angel told you, got to go back.
Mm-hmm.
Even though Sarah is wrong in the way she's treating you.
Yes, yes.
And she the one got you in this,
mm-hmm,
got you in that with her husband,
right,
out,
right,
of the will of God.
Yes,
and that's,
yes,
her whole scheme. And,
mm-hmm,
that she's all up in there.
Yes,
she's,
yeah,
all up in there because you got a baby now.
Right, yes.
By her husband. And you just a handmaid.
Yes.
And you feel like leaving now because,
yeah,
you said, I ain't got to take this.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The natural response was, I ain't got to take this.
Right.
And she left.
Mm-hmm.
And the angel said, you better get back in,
mm-hmm,
there.
Mm-hmm.
You better get back in there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Who was that? Naomi had to come back.
Naomi, after her husband
she
died.
She didn't want to come back.
And
she was
sons died.
And there was shame coming back.
Yeah.
And people said, oh, here she comes back now.
Uh-huh.
You better not pay attention to those people.
That's right.
Because
no,
baby, y'all going to find a Boaz here.
That's right.
Because he's not in that land y'all in.
No.
Amen.
No.
Y'all going to find a near kinsman, and y'all going to find a supply that you can never find,
yes,
in the wrong place.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So in the place God gives you is always provision.
Amen.
The Bible says, and this is probably a teaching in by itself, that Jesus would have a house.
Mm-hmm.
And it would be on the seashore. And I may have to give you that scripture, that he would have a house and it would be on the seashore. And it would let him know that, and it called it out,
mm-hmm,
that his home would be on the seashore,
mm-hmm,
to let him know that God had a house for him. Well, if God's got a house for Jesus, he's got a house,
amen,
for you.
Yes.
Over,
amen,
in the assignment that belongs to you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's over in Matthew chapter 4, verse 13. We'll take a look at that.
Mm-hmm.
Because that location became his ministry headquarters.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times people say, well, Jesus didn't have nowhere to lay his head. Oh, no. God ain't sent nobody here,
mm-hmm,
with the assignment and then give them no place to lay,
mm-hmm,
his head. And what he is talking about is, he's not talking about no place to lay his head. He's talking about the place of rest.
Mm-hmm.
A place of rest. His assignment,
mm-hmm,
was, the assignment was, kept him going.
Mm-hmm.
He's always moving. He's always,
mm-hmm,
on assignment.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't that he didn't have a house. His assignment was loaded.
Uh-huh.
God wanted to get a lot of things done through him.
Mm-hmm.
And then it says right here in Matthew 4:13, and leaving Nazareth, he came to dwell. And that word dwell means home.
Uh-huh.
He came to his home in Capernaum.
Mm-hmm.
He had a home in Capernaum, which is on the seacoast in the border of Zebulun and Naphtali. Jesus had a beachfront mm-hmm. house. And a lot of times, you know, you got to study this out and begin to look at it. All the training took place in a lot of that training took place in his home.
Mm-hmm.
That's why most of the miracles and most of the manifestation took place in Capernaum.
Mm-hmm.
When you read about the paralyzed man being lowered into the house. Mm-hmm. But that was his house.
Mm-hmm.
That's why nobody went off. Because I don't care. I don't care how much you say you say.
Right.
You're having some believers over, and then all of a sudden somebody's tearing off your house.
Mm-hmm.
You got a problem with that. The meeting is over.
Mm-hmm.
But that was Jesus's home.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't that where that took place. It was his house. Why? Because the Bible says, it told him he was going to live in Capernaum.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if we seek the kingdom first, just like you made, Matthew 6:33, you got a house here.
Thank
if
you.
Your assignment's in Nashville, you got a home in Nashville.
Yes, yes, yes.
And you just got to receive it.
Mm-hmm.
You got to, because you can't receive something you don't believe to be true.
Mm.
You got to believe that God has provision for
yes,
your life.
That's right.
He
yes.
says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and all the things that the Gentile is seeking after, it's going to be. Well, the Gentiles want beachfront
yes,
houses and
yes,
lakefront
yes,
houses.
Yes.
They want them too.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to seek God and understand that there's provision mm-hmm. for you, and it's provision
yes,
for your home,
yes.
and then the man and receive mm-hmm. it, and the manifestation will come.
Yes, yes.
God never gives assignment, purpose, and destiny without provision.
Mm-hmm.
And then he tells us what he wants us to do in that assignment. Well, over here in Genesis, let's go back to Genesis real quick. He tells Adam, I'm giving you this garden. I'm giving you this place of assignment.
Mm-hmm.
I'm putting you in a garden. In Genesis 2:15, it says, and Lord took the man and put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. That was his assignment. God is going to have a geographic place
mm-hmm.
of your assignment.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus, what he said his job was, his assignments. He sent to the lost sheep of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
And then his assignment was over in 1 John chapter 3, verse 8, is to undo all
mm-hmm.
the works of the enemy.
Mm-hmm.
So God gives, he gives likeness, he gives dominion,
mm-hmm.
he gives provision, and then he gives the task.
Mm-hmm.
He gives the day-to-day task and the assignment
mm-hmm.
of what you're supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
But what is our assignment? He says, go into all the world, preach the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
That's our assignment.
Mm-hmm.
To the geographical area he assigned me, then my job is to make sure
mm-hmm.
to live the gospel and then to minister the gospel out.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
And then we got a few more here. Then this last one, a lot of people struggle with this one. God does not want you broke.
Mm-hmm.
God has assigned wealth.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible said the wealth of the righteous, the wealth of the sinner, rather, is laid up for
mm-hmm.
the just. That's a real verse of scripture.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be a wealth transfer for this thing is all
mm-hmm.
over with. It has to be in order for us to get the gospel where it
mm-hmm.
needs to go.
Mm-hmm.
Wealth is going to move into the hands of the believer. And you need to believe God's plan.
Praise God.
Just like the transition took place in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
The wealth moved to God's people to do
mm.
what? To carry out the assignment. You can't fulfill the assignment out well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so over here in Genesis chapter 2, verse 12, the place where God put Adam, it says, and the gold of the land was good. And the bellium and the onyx stone. God put him in a place where there was jewels,
mm.
where there was provision and wealth.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Now, and then we go over here into Philippians 3. And Philippians 3, and I wrote that verse down. I want to take a look at that verse because Jesus is the wealth. Is not Philippians chapter 3. Philippians chapter 2, verse 9. Jesus is the wealthiest man
mm-hmm.
in all of existence. The Bible said because he took the cross,
mm-hmm.
God and death,
mm-hmm.
God highly exalted him
mm-hmm.
and raised him up and seated him at the highest seat. When it says highly exalted, it means to grant wealth, mm-hmm. opulence, and wealth. Mm-hmm. He is the wealthiest man in all of heaven and earth. Mm-hmm. Well, the Bible says to us over in 2 Corinthians chapter 8 and verse 9, you know the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. That though he was rich, yet for our sakes he became poor. Mm-hmm. That we through his poverty might be made rich. And it's not just talking about financially rich. It's rich in the Holy Ghost. Mm-hmm. It's rich in the word, rich in faith, peace. Rich in God, rich in love, rich in peace. But it includes rich in mm-hmm. wealth.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And so now you can take these scriptures and understand that God wants me to have his likeness, dominion, provision, mm-hmm. assignment, and wealth mm-hmm. is all supposed to be a part of my life mm-hmm. to carry out the plan of God.
Amen.
Amen. So take these scriptures and meditate on them. Praise God.
Yes.
Because if you're going to fulfill, if you're going to walk in the plan and destiny, mm-hmm. God's plan and destiny for your life, you're going to have that, the revelation of these things. Mm-hmm. So let's pray right now and believe that these things become a reality in our thinking.
Yes.
Amen. Heavenly Father, the Bible says that to be transformed yes. by the renewing of our minds.
Yes.
And we thank you for the ministry of the Holy Spirit,
mm-hmm.
that as we study the Word of God,
yes.
and as we are in the presence of the Holy Spirit,
mm-hmm.
always, he never leaves us.
Mm.
We thank you for the enlightenment to come.
Yes. Yes.
The enlightenment to come, that we have your likeness.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yes.
That we have your authorized dominion
mm-hmm.
and that we have your provision
yes.
and that we have your assignment on our lives
mm-hmm.
and that we have the wealth that you have given us through Jesus Christ
mm-hmm.
to carry out our assignment in earth. Let these truths become a part of our everyday lives
mm-hmm.
as we renew our minds,
yes.
as we put on the Lord Jesus Christ
mm-hmm.
in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we praise you and we thank you for it. We pray for those right now in the sound of our voice that are outside of this provision because they're outside of Christ,
mm-hmm.
that they don't have to stay that way.
That's right.
In the name
That's
of Jesus.
Right.
Right now, all you have to do is repeat this prayer after me.
Yes.
Because the Bible said if you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God and that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved.
Mm-hmm.
So, Father, just repeat after me. Say, Father God in heaven, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And I believe by the power of the Holy Spirit, you raised him from the dead. I believe it with all my heart.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to be left out of the plan of God. Mm-hmm. I want to be in your plan. I
yes.
want to fulfill the
yes.
destiny
yes.
that you have for me. I give up my plans and I receive your plans right
mm-hmm.
now in Jesus' name. I receive the nature.
Yes.
I receive the dominion.
Mm-hmm.
I receive the provision. I receive the assignment.
Mm-hmm.
I receive all that you have for me to stand perfect and complete in all the will of God. Right now, I take my place
yes.
in the family of God. I receive being born again
Thank
from
you,
above.
Father.
In
Thank
Jesus'
you, Lord.
Name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Well,
Thank
praise
you, Lord.
God.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But we're going to keep coming to you this way.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to be getting our information when we're going to start up
right.
back again, when we're going to start having our gatherings again. We're not that far away.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're looking at June the 7th.
Yeah.
Is that June the 7th?
Mm-hmm.
So mark your calendars. I believe June the 7th is the first Sunday in June.
Mm-hmm.
And we're looking to yeah. start back meeting on June the 7th.
We'll keep them updated.
And praise God, we'll keep you updated. We're going to let you know by Facebook and by YouTube and
yes.
by texting.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll let you know.
Amen.
But right now, the date is June the 7th.
Praise
we
God.
Just want to go ahead and get through May. We'll continue to do live streaming and
mm-hmm.
Until that date. But that's the date we're planning on coming back. Praise God.
Yes.
And,
Hallelujah.
And I'll be looking forward to
looking
seeing
forward.
All of you face to face. Hallelujah. But we want to come back. Praise God. With the word and with the spirit, and we won't come back on fire.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We're not just showing back up. We as a church,
That's right. yes.
and we as a church, we want to go to the next
Amen.
Level in the plan of God. Amen.
Ready to
Hallelujah.
Advance the kingdom of God in this earth.
Praise God. Our job is revival.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. A restoration of the plan of God
mm-hmm.
and moving in it to get our job done with
yes.
zeal. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So continue. Praise God. You're doing a great job in sowing seed.
Yes.
Remember, it's not about the money. It's about the honor that every time I give in respect to God, to his word, to his spirit, and to his purpose. and destiny on my life and on the church, that I want to see the things of God move forward. Mm-hmm. And as we honor God by honoring the things that He honors, and as we sow tithes and offering, expressing that financial honor, then God ministers that honor back to you. Mm-hmm. He's going to cause abundance of things to come your way. He's going to cause multiple places of increase, multiple direct increase, sources of increase to come into your life. Amen. You never go under honoring God. You go over the top honoring God. Mm-hmm. And one of the ways we do that is show so financial honor. Yes. You bring God honor when you bring Him money. Amen. Never just bring Him money. Always bring honor. Father, I respect You.
Yes.
That is the reason why I'm tithing. Mm-hmm. Father, I cherish, I honor the gospel of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. That is why I'm giving honors. I will honor financial honor. I want the word to go all over the world.
Thank you.
And I'm a part of bringing to pass the close and consummation of this age by taking the gospel all around the world and helping people's lives to be saved and changed.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Yes.
And remember, your supply is full. It's coming. It's here. It comes to pass. Financial increase
financial
is working
increase.
In our lives and millions on this congregation for this mighty, wonderful work. Be blessed and continue to have a great week in Jesus' name.
Yes.
And we'll see you next time.
All right.
Amen.